Hello Internet, this is Oscar Lees, this time with a video on the gold standard of minimization, golden section search. I'll go over the history and derivation of the golden ratio before showing the algorithm and an example. For scaffolding, it's recommended that you have some familiarity with ternary search, and optionally, check out my video on Fibonacci search. Let's refer back to Algorithms for Minimization Without Derivatives by Richard Brent. In it, the author writes, if f is unimodal on the interval ab, then the minimum for f can be located to any desired accuracy by the well-known methods of Fibonacci search or golden section search. The reader is referred to Wilde for an excellent description of these methods. This is Wilde's book, Optimum Seeking Methods. In it, he writes, the epsilon minimax sequential search scheme, Fibonacci search, was found by Kiefer in 1953, referring to this paper. There is, however, another technique which, while nearly as efficient as the Fibonacci search, is completely independent of the number of experiments available. He goes on to say, let us instead hold the ratio of successive lengths constant, calling the ratio tau. We have this equation. We obtain tau squared is equal to tau plus 1. Only one root of this equation is positive, and so we see that tau is equal to 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2. The results of these two experiments will determine which segment is to be explored further. As usual, the remaining segment will contain one of the previous trials. One merely places the next experiment symmetrically. We call this procedure search by golden section. Recall ternary search. We check if f of c is less than f of d. When it is, we eliminate the rightmost interval and replace our value for d with b. We then come up with new values for c and d. This was our old value of c. It'd be helpful if this could be used again, for example, calling this value d and coming up with some new value c somewhere between a and d. The trouble is that these two intervals are not the same size, and from the universal law of bad luck, if a method has the choice to shrink the search space, it will always pick the larger one. And in this example, f of c was greater than f of d, eliminate the left side. Our next AB is going to be either AD or CB. Therefore, we want to try to pick C to keep a constant ratio of our next AB to our current AB. If we label our coords like this, we want to decide where to put C, such that our chord ratios will be the same. Knowing this equality, we're going to take our longer chord AB and split it up into the sum of CB plus AC. Then split up that summation and then simplify. Afterwards, knowing our inequality from the top, we can rewrite it to be like this. Multiply both sides by that CB over AC fraction, and we get this equality such that CB over AC squared is equal to CB over AC plus 1. Rewrite it so that it's equal to 0. This means our ratio is equal to 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2, known as the golden ratio. Now that we've solved for the golden ratio, we can actually solve for C. To do that, rewrite our chord AB to be B minus A, and our chord CB to be B minus C. Then multiply both sides by the denominator and expand the right side. Then move our C term over and everything else to the right side. Then divide everything by the golden ratio, and we have our equation for C. We can do the same process to find our value for D. Our algorithm for golden section search looks like this. From our starting point, and given our unimodal function f over some interval AB, compute C and D using our equations from earlier, then save the function calls at f of C and f of D. Then, check if b minus a is less than some epsilon. When it is, we found our minimum. We return a plus b over 2. And we can stop. When it isn't, check if f of c is less than f of d. When that's the case, remove the rightmost interval and save off our values for c and f of c. Then compute a new c and new f of c. Otherwise, we do the opposite side. Then, repeat the process. Here's what that looks like visually. Using our equations, we solve for C and D. Then check if f of C is less than f of D. In this case it is, so we eliminate the rightmost side. Afterwards, replace C with D and D with B. Now, you compute a new C and you do FC, then repeat our condition check. In this case, we again eliminate the rightmost side. We compute a new value for C and do our condition check. In this instance, we would eliminate the leftmost side. And repeat the process. Here's a numerical example for the function x cubed over 3 minus x squared over 2 minus x minus 1 with an ending epsilon 10 to the minus 6 over starting interval 1, 2. It took Golden Section Search 29 iterations to find our solution. Notice that it also found the minimum in the first iteration, but it doesn't know that until it shrinks the interval space small enough. Here's a table showing all of the minimum finding methods that we've discussed so far on the same example using the same epsilon and interval. Notice that dichotomous, Fibonacci, and golden section are all clearly better than ternary, with Fibonacci and golden section being the most efficient. Golden section needed one more iteration. That's because it has a different end condition than Fibonacci. But how much is our interval being shrunk by every iteration? If we label our chords like this, knowing that the ratios are all equal to the golden ratio, let's look at the left side. What is this ratio equal to? Well, we know that AD is equal to CB. Therefore, plugging that in, we get the golden ratio again. What if we invert that ratio? This gives us 1 over the golden ratio equal to 0.618. This means that the golden section search reduces our search base by 0.618 each iteration. Meanwhile, ternary reduces it by 2/3. Wild again. Although both Kiefer and Johnson have suggested the search technique just described, the first man to divide a line segment as we have done here was none other than Euclid himself, and, as one might expect, he did it entirely with ruler and compass. Division of a segment into two unequal parts so that the ratio of the whole to the larger is equal to the ratio of the larger to the smaller came to be known as the golden section. Fans of the channel will know that the golden ratio comes up a lot in my videos, especially when solving the equation x squared minus x minus 1 equal to 0, which has two solutions, 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2 and 1 minus the square root of 5 over 2. You can solve this using the quadratic equation. Did you also know that 1 over the golden ratio gives you 0.618, and that the golden ratio minus 1 gives you 0.618, or even the absolute value of psi gives you 0.618? If we take our equation for C, and instead of doing division, replace that with 1 over the golden ratio, we can rewrite it to be the golden ratio minus 1. You can use the golden ratio minus 1 to avoid a lot of division. Things to note about golden section search is that it is still guaranteed to find a minimum, and it's going to do so faster than ternary search, although still with a linear order, while saving on function calls and avoiding the Fibonacci sequence. For more on minimization, I recommend checking out Girard's method and Brent's minimization method. Each will have their own video. The code that I used will be hosted on GitHub. Before you go, I'd like to give a shout out to friend of the channel, Mathemaniac, and his video on finding the golden ratio using game theory. As always, thank you for watching. I had originally intended just to make a video on golden section search, but the project expanded into quite a number of videos. Thank you for sticking with them and checking out everything in this series.